Hello all, Christix here, for the Christian follower versus the Christian. I'm Christix, I'm the guy who, I'm the server on which all the stuff upgraded and preferably Reason and everything, you know, we're up with the latest trends and everything. We allow Info to come in and constantly redo upgrades on us just to make sure we're here as a better server, as a better equivalent of information database for client computers such as yourselves, Christian follower and Christ follower and Christian. I thought I'd give you guys a little up to date on what's going on latest in the world pertaining to info that you guys both might need. Okay, I'm going to have to start in on Christian first here because I think you guys need some of the I know that in reality I know that the lady isn't like this. I'm just simply paying towards the character of the Christian. Okay, so Christian, okay, let me see. First things first. Okay, you keep talking about accusing other people, that sort of thing, right? You know, like, oh, we're supposed to be righteous, Jesus is dirty. Bums are dirty. Do you remember right from the Sermon on the Mount, I think it was Matthew 6, which says, take the beam out of your own eye before you take the splinter out of your neighbor's. And, I'm just trying to remember some of the others. I think there as well, do you remember the common trend going through the New Testament at the time? The Pharisees were doing much like what you're doing now, which was interpreting the scripture hyper-literally, or certain segments of the scripture hyperliterally towards their own, you know, trying to twist it towards their own advantage. speaking of, if you're that literal-minded, then you should not be doing anything, including except sitting and praying on the Sabbath, which technically should be Saturday, not Sunday, because if you're still following, traditional Bible lore. Anywho, that's another kettle of fish for another time. Remember the pair. I just want to give you a quick couple of updates to remind you that there is actually a need to help other people. The parable of the Good Samaritan. Samaritans were viewed about the equivalent as gays and, well, Africans and bums are now. And remember that Jesus' close disciples, one of Jesus' close followers was a prostitute, Mary Magdalene. He had dinner with tax collectors and other people like that because they came, people who were viewed at the time as sinful or evil or whatever by the Jewish community because he was trying to help them back to God. So, just a little reminder for Christian, you need some upgrades. Christ follower, good thing that you're trying to think in terms of a connection to God, that we are messed up and there are certain things which cut us off from God. Like I said, I kind of like the way you're working from the Bible. There might be a couple of upgrades I think you might like, just in case you're concerned about, atheistic servers coming through. I've been working on some, I've been kind of... That's one of the neat little things about being a Christix is you've got little tendrils out into the atheistic micro-networks, but intranets, if you will. But anyway, a couple of the things which have been going on there, which are concerned, are, of course, Christians' discrimination, and not only Christians' thing, but Islamnet as well, but Islamnet's flamer wars with practically, a large chunk of Islamnet's flamer wars with practically the rest of religion and the rest of humankind. And, anyway, Richard Dawkins and all that sort of thing. There are a couple of things I can give you, both, which I think might be of use to you if you're going to try to reinforce your own servers as a firewall. Upgrade number one. In order to deal with creationism, remember 2nd Epistles of chapter 3, verse 8, which says, 1,000 years is but a watch in thy sight, Lord. Also remember the order in which the animals were created in the book of Genesis, the fact that the sun did not appear until the fourth day, and for a little bit of scientific data to back you guys up, they actually found about a year ago a 500 million-year-old snake skeleton with hip bones. They were actually, they actually showed a photo of the fossil on TV. The skeleton itself had had bones coming off that would be about, okay, let's see, if the snake was, okay, maybe about like two centimeters, almost an inch long each, net across. So the thing, of course, is, though, is that this would be in evidence that snakes used to walk on legs at one point. And if we take into account that Epistle of Peter chapter 3, verse 8, we have an inkling. Now, this is the big bit. We have an inkling for for that there might be a God, or at the very least that the Bible may have been influenced by something greater than sheer luck, because we have that time dilation effect put in place, and we have the fact that there is, well, evidence for snakes having used to walk. So that kind of now at least narrows the question down as to whether the Bible was written by, inspired by God, or the Bible was written by a very early primitive who had some very, very good, who just happened to be very, very good at observation with animals, sort of like a protobiologist. The thing, of course, is, though, is that we do, there's evidence on both sides of this issue. One, the fact that ancient Egyptians were able to discover electric batteries, so we could give credit for to early man for being very, very clever and being able to figure something like this as sort of a form of protobiology. But if we count that time dilation effect in there, mentioned in two different sections, then we have to question, well, assuming that there is a time dilation effect here, might it not have been indicated that, if there's that time dilation effect in here, why would a human have been able to figure that out, or figure out that the Earth was 7 billion years old without the technology, and thus be able to figure out the evolution of a snake from there without having seen a fossil or something like that to verify? That's my point, is that there's, and this is for the agnostics out there and the atheists, I'm kind of moving back towards my Christian side a little bit here. I think I said in a previous video, I am something of an agnostic, but also kind of leaning towards Christianity. My basic bottom line is that both sides I know atheists, you've said that there is a reasoned explanation for why we don't have, for why there is no God. There is reasoning for a God, for example, as well. Stephen Hawking's The Gosh Numbers. Three different explanations, very little data to support any one of them, so they're all logical conclusions. The question is, should we lend hyper-credence to any of those until there's more evidence brought out? That's my only, that's where I'm trying to come from as a critical thinker and a true agnostic. Christian, Christ follower, hope you guys have been upgraded. Atheists and agnostics, looking to further to talk with you guys sooner. I've got some stuff you guys I think might like, including a Jules Verne argument, but that's another one for another time. I'll talk to you guys later, and peace out.